Hello students, in our previous videos we have seen types of meniscus. See here, you already know the types of meniscus. So meniscus means what? The upper surface of liquid. Suppose this one is the liquid we are taken in the glass tube. So suppose this one is the glass tube. And whatever will be the upper surface of the liquid, so this upper surface is called as meniscus. So this is meniscus. That is the upper surface of liquid. Now see here, this meniscus has three types. One is plain, another is concave, and third one is convex. So we have already discussed it in details in our previous videos. Today's our article is capillarity. Capillarity means what? See here, capillarity means just for that purpose you have to consider one capillary tube. So suppose this one is the capillary tube. Capillary tube means what? So it's like as the same structure, that is cylindrical structure, but its diameter is so small. So such type of glass tube is called as capillary tube. So capillary tube capillary tube, that is having small diameter, and it is a glass tube. So capillary tube means what? It is a glass tube and having very very small diameter. So that is capillary tube. So you have to use that capillary tube. See here, in first diagram we are taking here a glass container and water. So if we pour some water inside a glass container, then the meniscus of the ordinary water is obviously concave. So this meniscus is concave. We have seen already types of meniscus. Meniscus may be plain, may be concave, may be convex. Now when ordinary water in the glass container, then the surface of upper surface, that is the meniscus of that water, is concave. If we are taking here capillary tube and capillary tube is deep in the water, then what happened? Then you see here some water rises inside the capillary tube. It means that water moving in upward direction. See here, I have already put here h. So this h stands for the height of a liquid, means the water rises inside the capillary tube. So what is the reason behind it, scientific reason behind it, why the capillary tube deep inside the water, then the water move in upward direction? See here, in another case, glass container is there with mercury. So we have to dip a capillary tube in the mercury. Then what happened? Instead moving upward this liquid, it moved in downward direction. See here, h, that is the height, means liquid falls inside the capillary tube. See here, in first case we are taking water, in another case we are taking mercury. Means these two types of liquids are there. So one is water, another is mercury. But what happened? If capillary tube is deep in water, then water moves in upward direction. And if capillary tube deep in mercury, then mercury falls in downward direction. So see here, we have to discuss about the scientific reason behind it. Now, we have seen here the types of meniscus. See here, in case of ordinary water, there is concave meniscus, and in case of mercury, there is convex meniscus. So, when the meniscus is concave, then water rises or liquid rises, and when the meniscus is convex, then the liquid falls. So, whatever may be the liquid rise or falls, we can write here the rise or falls down of a liquid inside a capillary tube when it deep in the liquid. Is called capillarity. So this process is called as capillarity. Now, capillarity, that is the process in which liquid can move in upward direction or it move in downward direction. See here, when the liquid move in upward direction, when the shape of meniscus is concave. And when the liquid move in downward direction, when the meniscus is convex in nature. So this process is called as capillarity. Capillarity means what? So according to this conclusion, capillarity means what? Capillarity means liquid rises or liquid falls. So this liquid rises or liquid falls inside a capillary tube, this process is called as capillarity. See here, we have some examples of capillarity. So, which examples are there? See here, for that purpose, after bathing, this towel soak our sweat, or we can say liquids. So whatever may be the sweating, whatever may be the liquid absorbed by this towel, so this process is called as because it has some small number of pores. That's why it soaks all the liquids. Now another example, suppose we are taking a blotting paper and this ink and put on the marker at this point. So what happened? This ink absorbed by the blotting paper. So this is the reason, or this is the best example of capillarity. Another example, suppose a lamp is there, and in the lamp there is oil. So this is the wick. So this oil rises through the wick. This is also example of capillarity. So such many examples are there related to capillarity. Now see here, meniscus, that is meniscus means what? So these are the examples. Or we can say simply ink rises through the pen. This is also an example of capillarity. Okay. So see here. Capillarity means what we have seen already here. Now we are taking three cases which are there related to obviously meniscus. Suppose if the meniscus is plain, if the meniscus is plain means the upper surface of liquid is totally plain. Then what happened? Suppose this one is a meniscus. It is in plain in nature. So at that time, what happened? Two forces which are exactly opposite to each other and they are having equal magnitude. That's why the upper part and lower part, there is equal pressure. So in case of if the meniscus is plain, then they are having equal pressures. Means upper side and lower side, there is equal pressure when meniscus is plain. If the meniscus is concave, so if the meniscus is concave, it means that the pressure on concave side is greater than pressure on other side. What is the meaning of this? So meniscus is concave, then what happened? The pressure at this position, or we can say the pressure on concave side is greater than pressure on other side. Why this happened? Because the resultant force is in upward direction. So this is the resultant force Rf, which is in upward direction. That's why in case of if meniscus is concave, then definitely pressure on concave side is greater than pressure on other side. Suppose instead of concave meniscus, if we consider convex meniscus, then what happened? See here, what happened? Suppose instead of concave meniscus, if we consider the meniscus is convex. So just consider this one is the convex meniscus, that is the upper surface of liquid, it is in convex. Then what happened? So this part having greater pressure than this part, means pressure on concave side. So this one is the concave side. Yes. Inner part. So inner part, it has concave. So whatever the pressure on this concave side is always greater than pressure on other side. Other side means what? Convex side. Here other side, here also other side represents what? Obviously convex side. See here, meniscus, if it is concave or convex, the pressure definitely on concave side is greater than pressure on convex side. So you should remember all of these things, because we have to find the reason between why the reason for capillarity, means why the liquid rises inside the capillary tube and why the liquid falls inside the capillary tube in case of multiple. So we have to find the scientific reason. Find the scientific reason why the water rises inside the capillary tube. Means if the capillary tube deep inside the liquid, then what happened? Then the water is moving in upward direction. So why it is moving in upward direction, or why we can say water rises in capillary tube when it is deep in the water? So there is scientific reason. So for that purpose, here we are considering a glass container with water. So this is water, And we dip here one capillary tube. So this one is the capillary tube. This is the capillary tube. And we dip here a capillary tube in the water. Then the water is moving in upward direction. So while it is moving in upward direction, there is a concave meniscus inside the capillary tube. So this is the capillary tube. So while the water rises inside the capillary tube, then there is an upper surface which is in concave nature. So here four points we are considering. One is A. A point is above the concave surface, and B point is below the concave surface. But see here, A and B. See here. See here, A is above the concave surface and B is below the concave surface. But this A point and B point both are present inside the capillary tube. So we can say both are in inside capillary tube, but A is above the concave surface, C here above the concave surface, and B is below the concave surface. Okay. So we have seen that is the pressure is greater than the pressure on concave side is always greater than pressure on other side. So here we can considering that is PA, that is pressure at A point, similarly PB, PC and PD. So these are the pressure at different points, PA, PB, PC and PD. Here PA is greater than PB, we can say. So if surface is, if upper surface, or we can say meniscus, is concave, then pressure on concave side, is always greater than other side. Other side means what? Convex side. So we have seen in our previous lectures. So we have seen in our previous articles that is concave surface, the pressure on concave surface is always than pressure on other side. Other side means what? This is articles that is concave surface. The pressure on concave surface is always than pressure on other side. Other side means what? This is convex side. So that's why we can write here PA is greater than PB. Why we are writing here PA is greater than PB? Because A point is above the concave surface and B point is below the concave surface. So which pressure is greater? So the point which is above the concave surface, the pressure at that point is definitely greater. Okay, so this is our first equation. Now see here, point C and point D, both are outside the capillary tube and they are situated. C point is situated above the plane surface and D point is situated below the plane surface. So the pressure is same. The pressure is same. Means there is no pressure difference at all. At which condition? When the surface is plane. The pressure is same on both sides. On both side of a plane surface, you listen carefully. If the meniscus is plane, means the upper surface is plane, then there is no pressure difference. Means pressure above the plane surface and below the plane surface, it is equal, or we can say same. So that's why we can write here pressure at C point must be equal to pressure at any point. And this is our second equation. PC is exactly equal to PD. Why both the pressures are set? Because meniscus is plane. Therefore, there is no pressure difference. Now, pressure A point and C point both are in air medium. So that's why some pressure acting on that point. And obviously that pressure is called as what? Atmospheric pressure. Yes, correct. Now see, the atmospheric pressure, the atmospheric pressure is same. That's why we can write PA is equal to PC. Equation number 3. Pressure at A point and pressure at C point, both pressures are equal. Why? Because both points are situated in air medium. So that's why the atmospheric pressure is same for A point as well as C points. So our conclusion is, if PA is equal to PC and PC is equal to PD, so obviously we conclude that PA is equal to PD. So instead of from first equation, we can write from equation 1, PA is greater than PD. PA is greater than PD. We have seen this equation, but PA is equal to PC and PC is equal to PD. Therefore, PA is exactly equal to PD. So therefore, instead of PA, we can write what? PD. So use here instead of PA. So instead of this PA, we can write here PD. So therefore, our conclusion is PD is greater than PD. Equation number 4. Concepted here, what we have done here, PA is equal to PC, PC is equal to PD, so obviously PA is equal to what? PD. So instead of PA, we can use what? PD. So therefore, our equation is PD is greater than PB. Now what is PD? See here, D point, which is outside the capillary tube, B point, so B point is inside the capillary tube. It means that PD represents outside pressure of the capillary tube and PB represents inside pressure in capillary tube. So we can say here outside pressure is greater than inside pressure. Is greater than inside pressure. See here. In this article, we conclude that outside pressure of the capillary tube is always greater than inside pressure in the capillary tube. So this is the reason the water rises inside the capillary tube, up to which outside and inside pressure must be equal. So when outside and inside, these two pressures, outside and inside, these two pressure becomes equal or becomes remain same, up to that point that water rises inside the capillary tube. So due to this pressure difference, concentrate on this equation 4. So due to pressure difference, which pressure difference is there? PD is greater than PB. It means that outside the pressure is always greater than inside the inside pressure in capillary tube. So that's why water is moving in upward direction. But up to which point it is moving in upward direction? When outside and inside pressure remains same. So when the outside and inside pressure remains the same, up to that point, this water rises inside the capillary tubes. Thank you.